Do you feel alone? Do you feel like no one will understand what's going on in your life, the dilemma that you're in or the situation that you're in? So you just feel withdrawn and like no one would care, even if you told them? Well, I want you to know you're not alone. You're not the only person going through this. I've been there. I've spoken to hundreds, if not thousands, of others who have been there, and I've read about literally hundreds and hundreds of other people who have been there. When you're away from God, when you're isolated, when you have these things going on in your life that you just don't know how to deal with, you get this alone, this loneliness. You get this feeling of just being alone. No one cares. Even God doesn't care. And if that's where you are, I want to share some things with you. I want to encourage you. You think about the story of Jonah. What did Jonah do when everything was going on? He went down below the ship and went to sleep. What do you do when you escape like that, when you withdraw like that? You're getting out of the situation. You're withdrawing from it. You're saying, I don't want to play anymore. This is no fun. I don't want to be part of this. No, thank you. But instead of Jonah really looking at what did he need to do, and in my own life at times looking at, hey, this is what I need to do, instead of doing that, it's just easier to go to sleep. The depression, the conflict, or whatever's going on, it's just easier to ignore it. But are you ready for some really awesome news that what God's Word says? In 1 Corinthians 10:13. God's Word says that He will never, ever give us more than we're able to bear. And at times, I have to be honest with you, in my own life, I'm like, God, you must think I'm a lot stronger than I actually am, because I don't think, and there's the problem right there, I put myself into it, right? God knows more about me and God knows more about you than we will ever know about ourselves. And so God's Scripture clearly says He will never give us more than we can bear. This means that He'll only give us what we're able to bear. But that means we got to lean on Him. That means we got to go to Him and ask for His help and ask for His guidance and ask for His abilities and His wisdom that we can bear this burden. It also means that we have to go to other brothers and sisters in Christ. We have to ask them. Galatians 6:2 instructs us, tells us clearly, bear ye one another's burdens. Well, let me ask you this. How can someone help you bear your burden, including God, if you're not talking to them about it? If you're not taking your burden to God and laying it there and saying, God, I need your help. I can't do it alone. Or you're not going to a Christian brother, or you're not going to a Christian sister and saying, hey, I've got some issues here. And this is one thing I'm guilty of in my life, in the past and still even in the present, of not wanting to share for multiple reasons, from being embarrassed or being, you know, guilty, or what will they think, or what will they say, or they won't understand, no one will understand what all these things that run through my mind. And I'm sure they run through your mind as well. But the Scripture is very clear. He won't give us more than we can bear. And we're to bear each other's burdens. That means we're supposed to share with each other and pray for each other. So I want to encourage you. If you're in that situation, take it to God. Take it to others. Share it with them. Get out of that mindset of the emotions and the thoughts and the what if I do this and what's holding you back and why I can't. Put it to the side, because you're not the only one who's going through it. You're not the only one who's there. You're not the only one who's been through it. Others know. And if you will find someone who's truly walking with the Lord, someone who has a relationship with Jesus Christ and is in God's Word, they're going to have compassion. They're going to have understanding, because they've been in the same situation. They might even be in the same situation at the time, and you all can help each other. So start focusing on God. Start focusing on God's Word. Start focusing on His promises. And stop letting those things, whatever's going on in your mind, whatever it is, start looking to God's Word. Now, if you say, hey, I need some more help on this, well, I've written a book called Modern Day Jonah, and you can download it for free at handlinglife.org/program. It's my personal story. It's my struggles. It's my failures. It's my accomplishments. It's what God has done for me in my life. It's steps that I took. It's all Bible-based. It's all Christ-centered. It talks about how I felt alone. It talks about how I felt that I couldn't even talk to, you know, my pastor or my wife about things that were going on in my life. And what I found out later is they already knew. But this book is free. It's called Modern Day Jonah, Stop Surviving, Start Living. So if you're caught in that situation where you feel alone and you just don't know what to do, go to handlinglife.org/program and download the free book and start looking at what somebody else's story is. What did they do out of God's Word to start getting, you know, back to where God wants you to be? And God wants you to be joyful. God wants you to have peace and contentment and balance in your life. But we got to do it His way. We got to apply His Word to our life. And I can look in my life and I can say the times when I've had the biggest struggles, the times when I felt the most alone, and all of that, my relationship with God was sparse. There wasn't much of one. And now that I look back and see that, when I feel myself slipping into that loneliness, I start trying to build my relationship back stronger with God. I hope this has been an encouragement to you. I hope you'll share it with others, and I hope you'll take this and apply it to your life. And if you want to learn more about the Handling Life ministry, you can visit handlinglife.org.